Hey guys, today I'm at a forest park and I'm going to be trying out a new panfish bait. The subject of today's test is going to be the Berkley Gulp Alive Waxies / Asticots. I have never used these things before and I don't know if they work that well, but we're going to find out.
Let's give it a shot.
I'm going with a very basic setup today. I got a cigar-shaped float and under that I've got a 1/64 ounce jig head with the Waxie baited on the bend of the hook. So these little creeks I got here all throughout Forest Park are just full of panfish, and I think it's just now warm enough where they're starting to come up and get active, getting ready for the spawn. Got him. There's a fish. All right, what do we got? Let's put up a good fight. I don't think he's gonna be terribly big. What is this? Is this? I don't know what this is. It's not a panfish. What in the world is this? Is that a little catfish? Oh my word. What? I came out here for panfish and caught a freaking catfish instead. And then he just broke my hook.
Excellent! Yeah!
Look at that little channel cat. I was not aware that they had these guys in these creeks, but hey, this is a welcome surprise. Hey buddy, I was coming out here for some of your prey. You know, those panfish that you like to eat when you get a little bit bigger, but you know what? I'm glad to catch you. How about we throw you back now, all right? See you, buddy. I'm gonna go without the float for a moment. Just took it off my rig. Go with just the jig head and see if that'll trigger something, get it dancing around a little bit more than it would be on a bobber. It's not terribly windy out here, so I don't think it would be doing that with a bobber, but see if just jigging it up and down like this on the bottom triggers some fish into biting. Because I mean, every time I fish around this bridge, there are fish to be caught. There's the little fish. My gosh, it's a tiny little largemouth bass.
Put me under a microscope?
You've got to be joking me. Man, I came out here for some panfish, and the two fish I've caught are a small catfish and a small little fried bass. But given how slow the production was on the other side of the bridge, I'm going to move to this side to see if I can find something else. There's a fish. Oh, it's a hard fighting fish too. Heck yeah. What do we got here? Oh, look at this. I think this is some kind of like a golden shiner, I think. I'm gonna have to do a little research and I will put the name of it right here underneath the fish. That's what this is. And I guarantee you that would be some
Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? The audio dropped out again.
Hey Johnny, what happened with that new mic we ordered? What? It's not gonna be here for 2 months? Bro, we have serious audio issues right now. If we don't get this fixed, viewers are gonna figure out we're total hack frauds. Ah crap, the mic's still on.
We can edit this out, right?
Yeah, now that the wind's picking up, I may have to go back to that bobber. The wind is just gonna lift this jig all the way up to the top of the water. Got him. There's a little fish. Little gill. Hey, Mr. Gill, what's going on? You're probably not having a good evening all of a sudden. I apologize, but not really. Yeah, I think I'd hang on to you for some bait. You'd work. Go on and get bigger for me. Oh yeah, buddy, we're on them now. Oh yes, sir. Oh, we are on them now. Yeah, this one's putting up a good fight. Not terribly big, but he's a welcome sight. Any fish is a welcome sight. Bigger ones are more preferred, but hey. They may not be primo, but they're a good time. See you, buddy.
Nice.
Oh yeah, we got this front moving in now for sure. Wind's picking up. Clouds are starting to get dark off to my left. It'd be down to the south. When I was looking at the radar, it was saying that the front was going to be blowing to the south side of St. Louis. That's definitely where it's at. Hopefully it stays that way, doesn't come across Central City like where I'm at. But I gotta say, so far the Waxies are working. I think it just may be At least for this time of year in this piece of water, maybe the fish aren't quite as active as I'd like them to be. They're definitely not in the spots that I normally catch them. I really thought they'd be around the bridge because that's where they're normally at, but maybe later in the summer, later spring, they'll be up and around there. Maybe these are the spots where they make their beds. Oop, well, that was a hit and I wasn't paying attention. Dadgummit, Chris, you gotta be paying attention to that kind of thing. You're gonna let some fish get away just like that. Move down a little bit, see if we can find another pocket. Well, that ain't cool. I lost my entire daggum rig. Ugh.
Air ball.
Got my new rig ready to go. Let's catch some more fish. Let's flip it over to the other side and see what's over there, if anything. Ooh, let's try to stay out of that tree, shall we? Got him. I think we got a fish. Now we're talking. We're back in business, baby. Ooh, it's a fighting fish too. He's giving me a good time. What do we got? I think we got a bluegill. Yeah, a little bluegill. Not bad. I think it's a little hybrid, but you know what that is. That'd be going in the bait bucket if it was going out for some flathead and blue.
Storm's coming up, honey. You better get home quick.
All right, guys, the storm is right on top of me, and while I'm not afraid of fishing in the rain, I am terrified of waving a fiberglass rod in the air in a thunderstorm. My assessment on the waxies, I think they work. It may be a little bit too early for me to say that the fish are totally active, but I think I have to put them definitely underneath the Berkley Gulp minnow and probably underneath the night crawlers. If you guys want to check out some more of my videos, I got a couple options you can pick from right here. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.